Alright, today we're going to be playing a 1500 point Dropzone Commander game. We have Scourge versus UCM. First up, we have Sam playing Scourge. He's going to go over his army list right now.
Alright, so this is 1500 points of Scourge. I've got an HQ formation here. It's going to be a Desolator with command value 4, that makes him a master. And then 4 Reavers in that same group. I've got 2 identical detachments, 2 occupation patrols, each one with a pair of destroyer stands in an intruder alpha, and 4 minders in an intruder beta. So 2 units there, pretty nasty. I've got 1 unit of warriors. It's going to be 2 squads of 3 stands in an invader. Then I also have a vanguard unit with 4 hunters, the tank, anti-tank vehicles, and then 4 reapers, the anti-air vehicles. And finally, I have an attack swarm, which is going to be 2 units of 2 corsairs, so I have a little bit of flexibility there.
I only see 3 there, so should there be 4?
Oh, of these.
Oh, those. Okay.
Yeah, sorry.
Cool. All right. Cool, thanks. That is the Scourge. All right, next up we have the UCM. We have 6 detachments. We have a captain in a Phoenix, and in his group, he also has a elite squad of Praetorians in their dropship and an Eagle gunship. Then we have an infantry detachment with rapiers, anti-air, and their dropship, 2 squads of 2 stand legionnaires with their light dropships. We have a little bitty battle group with just 1 dropship and 2 legionnaires. We have a tank battle group with 2 katanas and 2 falcon gunships. Another tank battle group with 3 katanas, 3 rapiers, and a dropship for the rapiers. The katanas will be driving on. And then last but not least, I have an air detachment with 1 archangel fighter. So hopefully that can stave off the Scourge. So that's it for the UCM. All right, so we rolled for the mission. It's going to be recon. We're playing on a 4x6 game board. We've already set out the recon. Every building is going to have a intel token on it. When an infantry unit gets into the building, they roll to see what it is. It might explode. It might be some important stuff that you could pull off the board or just for a point. So that's our table. We're going to roll off for sides here a minute and start deployment. Table sides, I've got this side here. Sam and his Scourge are going to be deploying on the other side. Just to clarify the intel, when an infantry gets into the building on the next turn, they roll a die on a 6. It becomes an objective that they can withdraw off the table and you get a point. If it's a 2 through 5, it just scores a point. And if it's a 1, it explodes and hurts the building and possibly the infantry. So that's how the intel works. Now we've got our initiative roll. Sam has a 1 higher commander than me, so he's going to get a a +4 to my +3, I guess. So here we go. So, a 5, 2, 1. All right. All right, so the UCM will actually have Sam move first, so the Scourge will take the first activation. All right, so for Scourge first activation, we have 2, what are these, Sam?
Intruders.
Intruders, here and here, driving on. Both of those contain a squad of warriors. Off to UCM activation 1. All right, UCM activation 1, we had the small infantry battle group activate. Raven came in, deposited a squad of legionnaires into this building so they could search for intel next turn. Scourge activation 2. All right, so Scourge, second activation, they drove on some hunters. Those are the grav tanks and reavers, which are anti-air. All right, we forgot we're going to have to go back to roll for our air power in reserve. On turn 1, you need a 6 to get in reserve. Sam has 2 units of 2 Scourge Corsairs, so he's going to roll for both of those at the same time since they're identical. So what do you get, Sam? So So one unit comes in. And then for the UCM, nada. All right. So on to UCM's second activation. All right, for UCM's second activation, I brought in my second infantry battle group. We had a Condor bringing in some Rapier anti-aircraft tanks. So they deployed. They can't shoot this turn, but they are ready for next turn. Two Ravens brought in two more squads of Legionnaires and put them in buildings. This tall building has a squad of Legionnaires that are also my forward observers. They are not on the wall, they are still inside, so they are safe from shooting, hopefully. That is UCM Activation 2 onto Scourge 3. Alright, so Sam is trying to bring in his air. He needs to do it on a 2+. Alright, they're in.
There we go.
Alright, so Sam's Scourge, his two Corsairs are making an attack run on this Raven. So he's going to go ahead and roll to hit, one shot for each one on a 4+.
Okay, first one, hit.
It's a hit.
Second one, also a hit.
All right, and then the Raven's armor is a 5, so you need a 2+ to destroy.
Okay, first one, got him.
And he's destroyed. All right, so the next UCM activation is a tank battle group driving on 3 katanas. So they moved on 3 inches. And they are firing on a small building across the board. They can shoot 48 inches with their no countermeasures. Each one gets 2 shots. And we missed the building 3 times. It's energy 9 versus the building of 6, so I damage on a 2+. Or is that 3+?
2+.
2+. So we do 5 points of damage. So anything that's 2 more than you're required to hit, so 4 better at this point counts as 2 damage, so 5 total to that building. The last unit in that same battle group is a unit of Rapiers with a Condor. They got dropped off there, so they can't shoot, but the Condor is going to fire at the same small building. We need a 2+ to hit, and we miss. How about that? Right, so Scourge's fourth activation, they're getting aggressive. They had a light dropship here bringing destroyers, heavy infantry, so that flew quite a way across the board. And then another light dropship carrying minders, which are floating AA annoyance units. So that was the Scourge fourth activation going over to back to UCM. All right, for the UCM's fourth activation, we drove on another squad of katanas. They're going to fire at the same small building. It has 5 damage points left. We're going again with 6 shots, needing 2s to hit the building. So that's a little bit better. We hit 5 times. And then to damage, also on a 2+. And I think that's enough, Sam, to drop the building. So that right. Building is toast. Alright, the last unit in that battle group is a unit of 2 Falcon gunships. They moved on 12. They're firing on that medium building there. They each get 1 shot at energy 11, needing a 2+ to hit. So that's 2 hits. And then 2+ to damage. So we got a 3 and a 3, so that's 2 damage points on that building. Alright, for Scourge activation, it looks like Sammy brought in your minders on a light dropship to counter my Falcons. They're still on board, though. They haven't disembarked. And then another unit of destroyers in their light dropship. And again, they haven't disembarked, but they are being quite aggressive getting in the UCM's face. Okay, to round out the last UCM activation, I brought on this Falcon gunship with some Praetorians. So they're the elite infantry, and they're going to stay in their dropship as kind of a reactionary force. And then we have the mighty Phoenix command vehicle flying on board, and it's going to fire at that same building that has 10 damage. We've got 2 energy 12 chain guns that hit on a 2+, and 1 misses. And then we have 2 missile pods, which both miss. So only 1 hit on that building, 2+ to damage the building, and we score 2 points of damage. So that building is now at 12 out of 20, so it's more than halfway on its way to destruction. Alright, so for the Scourge last activation, they brought on four Reavers. Those are gunships, pretty nasty, so one unit of four, and then the commander's tooling around in his Desolator, so there he is. So that concludes turn one. We're going to go ahead and wrap up here in just a sec. Alright, so we've concluded turn one. Not too much has happened. The UCM has come on, pretty much claimed this corner of the board. This Scourge have come on in the backfield with their tanks and have been pretty aggressive here with gunships, infantry toting dropships, and their commander coming up. The only losses so far are one UCM dropship has been shot down by Scourge fighters, and one building has been destroyed by the UCM in retribution. All right, so we're going to start turn two, and we'll see where this goes. All right, so we're starting to turn two. The very first thing we do is we roll for initiative. Sam and I's commanders are still alive, so he's getting, in essence, a plus one on his die roll for initiative. So here's UCM, six, and one. Okay, so UCM is going to be going first. Alright, so after initiative, we drew up cards. Now we're rolling to see if our heir comes in for reserve. Sam has one unit of two Corsairs left, so he's going to be rolling for that, looking for a 4 plus to bring him on.
Nope.
And they don't. And then I have one Archangel, 4 plus to bring him on, and he comes on. So that's it for heir. I now have some heir to counteract all those Corsairs. Alright, for UCM's first activation, I activated my tank battle group. This unit of katanas drove forward 6 inches. They're going to fire into that building that's already damaged. I have 6 shots hitting on 2. So, again, we've got 1 miss, 5 hits. I need a 2 to damage and a 4 or higher to double damage. So we have 1 miss and looks like 6 damage there total on that building. So it is now at 18, 2 more to go. Okay, the second part of that battle group was a unit of Rapiers AA tanks. They're going to stay put, hold their shots for reaction fire for Sam's inevitable horde of flyers. Their dropship, however, flew forward, and it's going to be firing its rocket pod on that damaged building, hopefully finishing it off. So it needs a 2 plus to hit, and we hit, and it needs a 2 plus to damage, 4 plus for double damage. We got the double damage, which is enough to drop the building and destroy the intel within. Alright, so now we're on to Scourge's first activation in turn 2. Alright, so Scourge has activated one of their infantry groups. These destroyers have climbed out of their vehicle and climbed into that building, again right in front of the UCM, and now Sam's going to be moving his Minder unit. Alright, so the Minders have moved forward. They've deployed and kind of floated towards my Falcon gunships. So we'll see what we have to do there to move those guys. Alright, so for UCM second activation, second tank battle group, these katanas under here drove forward with their compatriots. They are now shooting their 6 shots at that small building over there across the board. So here we go, 2 plus to hit. They all hit. And then 2 plus to damage the building. So we've got 1 miss. And then we've got 3 double damage, so 6, 7, 8 damage onto them. All right, then to conclude that battle group, we have 2 Falcon gunships. They are going to shoot first. So they're going to go after that small building that now only has 2 damage points left. They need 2s to hit, which they do, and then they need 2s to damage, 4s for double damage. So that is enough to drop that building and destroy it. Then for their movement, they're moving 12 inches back here. Okay, so for Sam's activation, he moved up his hunters here, coming up the street, and then his AA Reapers moved up more towards the middle of the table. We're going to go back. Sam had wanted to bring in these... what are these guys again, Sam?
Reavers.
Reavers, and bring them in below the deck. So he's going to make four to the deck rolls for those guys.
Do you want my Desolator, too?
Oh, and the Desolator as well.
All right, so... First one? Fine.
We're good.
Next one? Good. Third one? Ooh, close.
And we're looking for twos to crash, otherwise you're safe.
And last one. Good.
A total of two.
And the Desolator. Oh, good.
Well.
Making me sweat there.
Alright, so my next activation, I'm just going to activate my small infantry battle group. It's just this two legionnaires and their falcon. Those guys are starting the turn in the building, so they can roll for intel. So here's my intel roll. And it's a four, so I score one point. The intel will stay there, so Sam and his Scourge could conceivably score that intel at a later point of the game. But I score 1 point, so it's 1-2-0. So Sam activated his warrior group. One warrior transport here is just sidling up to the destroyed building. His other, where'd they go? Oh, they piled out into this building with intel. So that is Sam's Scourge activation. Back to UCM. All right, for UCM activation, we are activating our command group. The Phoenix has moved over here and is going to be firing into this building with destroyers. I'm going to use my missile first. I have a limit two missile, so one of two. That's going to hit the building on a two plus. And we've scored a hit. That is a demo four, because it's a demo two and it's a blast. So here's the damage, and we do nothing. And then we have two energy 11, our energy 12 guns, only one of those hits, and a 2 plus damage, we get 2-5, so that scores 2 damage. And so that is 2 falling masonry tests for Scourge on a 5 plus. So we get 1 falling masonry, and I believe that's an energy 6 versus whatever your armor is.
Armor 4.
So that would be a 3 plus. Do you have any special rule with those guys? And
they are tough, so I can ignore... they always damage me on a 5 plus.
Okay.
And I have a 4 plus passive countermeasure.
Alright, so I need a 3 plus to kill a guy, which we get, and then you have a countermeasure for that damage? Okay. So there we've got no. So that's one destroyer dead. Command battle group. The Eagle gunship is going to fire into that same building with the destroyers. So here we go. We've got two Energy 11 rail guns. And of course, one of those misses. And that's going to damage on a 2 plus. So we've got 2 damage so far. Then we have 4 shots with missile pods all hitting on 2s. So we got 4 hits there, and those are also going to be damaging on, those will damage on 4 plus. So we got 2 double damage, so 4 more damage there. So that's 6 total for that building from the Eagle, so that's 6 more falling masonry tests. So we got 3 falling masonry hits, and I only damage those warriors on a 5.
Yeah.
So we got 1, and then Sam has his passive save, which he makes. So no dead there. The last activation for this battle group is the Praetorians. So their dropship came here behind the building, and they climbed out into that building so they could search for intel next turn. So that's a command battle group activation for UCM. We'll back over to the Scourge. Sam is activating his other infantry group. Those minders, or their dropship anyway, is going to be trying to go to the deck, so we're going to make it go to the deck. And he's good. All right, so the minders have disembarked and come around the corner. I've got 2 Rapier AA tanks that are going to reaction fire. Normally they would be hitting those guys on a 3, but since it's reaction fire, it's going to be a 5. So we're looking for 5s to hit with 6 shots. Oh, wait, I've got to declare targets, right?
Yeah.
So we'll do... 3 on the first one, and 3 on the second one here. Alright, so here's the first guy. Nothing. And then for the second guy, we got two hits. And then two plus two damage. It's energy 7 versus armor 2. And we're glad we hit it with 2, so it takes 1 damage.
Alright.
And then we have the destroyer's dropship flew across the board, and the destroyers climbed into this building with my legionnaires, and there looks like there might be a skerfuffle later. UCM's activation, I'm going to go with my infantry battle group. First up, these guys in here are going to search for intel. So let's hope it's something we can pull, or maybe the building will explode, who knows. Alright, so it's just an intel for me, so that gives me 2 points. They are going to exit the street. I have to be within base contact of each other when they're on the street. For my next activation, I'm activating this unit of legionnaires. They are also going to search for intel, and they roll a 1. So that turns into an explosion, right?
Yes.
Yeah. And then we'll have to check the stats on that explosion, and we'll get back to that excitement. So it's a d6 damage points to that building. So we're going to roll, and we get 5 hits on that building. So Sam's going to make 5 falling masonry tests on my guys.
2.
And that looks like 2. And then you're going to damage my guys on a 2+. So 4. We've got 4 guys dead. After that building exploded, those guys jumped back into their dropship and it flew over here 12 inches. The last action for this battle group is 2 out of 3 of my rapiers are going to be firing into these minders here. We are shooting 3 dice at each one of the lead 2. So the guy in the lead, we're hitting now on 3s. So we hit him twice and we damage him on 2s, so he's gone. And then the next guy also gets 3 shots, and we've got 1 hit, and we need 2s to damage, and that kills him as well. And that finishes that battle group. Back over to Scourge. He's bringing in his heir. He needs to bring in the Corsairs on a 2+. And they're in. And they're going to be making an attack run down the street at this rapier that didn't fire. I will be getting reaction fire. I have 1 rapier that didn't fire here, and we already pre-measured. This Phoenix is going to be able to get its AA shots off as well. So we've got a couple of AA that are going to be hitting Corsairs on a... Is it going to be a 5 for them as well, Sam?
Yeah, it'll be a +2.
+2
for reaction fire.
Alright, so the rapier would actually fire first because his reaction fire is a little bit further down the street than the Phoenix. So that's going to give us 3 shots, looking for 5s. Ooh. And we score 2 hits. And that's energy 7 versus your Corsair's armor of
5.
So it's, I need 3s to score a damage point, 5s to score double damage. Ooh. So that's 2 damage points on the lead Corsair, which is enough to destroy it. Then as we get to the corner, the Phoenix has 2 shots. Also needing 5s. I got 1 hit. It is energy 6, so I will be only damaging you on a 4 and a 6 for double damage. So he's fine, and he can continue with his attack run.
Okay. Alright, so I hit you on a 4+. I got 1 shot.
Misses. Next up, I'm going to try to bring in my heir. I need a 2+ to bring it in, and it's brought in. The Archangel is going to fly along the street and try to take out one of these 2 minders. I've got 2 shots, energy 7, needing a 3 to hit. So we got 1 hit, and energy 7 versus armor
3
is 2+. So we got 1 damage point. And then he travels down the street and goes back in. All right, so Sam is activating the Scourge command group, and he's playing a card on his Reaper squad.
So I'm playing aggression on the Reapers. So all weapons that this squad fires can reroll misses during this turn, and then until they're activated again, they'll be one easier to hit by John.
All right, so they're easier to hit, but they're also hitting a lot harder. All right, so let's see where those guys go. So they're coming after this Rapier AA group here. One of these tanks has not fired, so it's going to fire its reaction fire shots as soon as he can see them. So that's going to give me three shots, needing fives to hit. So we got two hits there. Sorry, Sam. And then that's energy seven versus
armor five.
So threes to damage, fives to double damage. So no damage. So they can move in and do all the nastiness they want. All right, so Sam has moved up here into the alley. He is firing. Which one do you want to do first, Sam?
Do this Reaper firing into this Reaper.
All right. So,
two plasma lances and a plasma hose.
Okay.
So here's the lances hitting on threes. I missed one, but I'll reroll with my aggression card. So two hits.
Okay. And I'm armor 10.
Right. And they're strength 10.
So fives to destroy.
No.
Okay.
And then I have one plasma hose that will also hit on a three. And then reroll for aggression. Missed. All right. And then my second one will be this one into that Rapier. Two plasma hoses, or plasma lances. Both hit.
Okay.
And then need fives. Oh.
Oh!
And then one plasma hose. Hits, and needs a six. All right.
And then what's last is?
The back two will fire into the front one.
Leave him. So four plasma lances.
Four plasma lances. All hit with threes. Nice.
So you got to get one here.
All right. One five of us.
Yes, there you go.
There
so six. So that destroys the lead Rapier.
And then the hoses have nothing to shoot at.
All right. So that could have been worse. I'm down one Rapier out of that. All right. So at the conclusion of turn two, the kill count is the Scourge have lost four Minders, Corsair, which is their fast-moving fighter. The UCM has lost a dropship and a Rapier AA tank. I've also lost four infantrymen out of one of my Legionnaire platoons, and I believe Sam has lost one destroyer out of a destroyer platoon. So now we are going into turn three. UCM is now leading 2-0. All right, so turn three, here's the initiative roll. UCM got a three, and Sam got a six, so he wins it handily. So, Sam, are you going to be activating first?
I will activate first.
All right, so we're off to draw card. In the cleanup phase, Sam is playing a global card.
Okay. Playing Overdrive, and it affects all friendly vehicle squads. Each friendly vehicle squad may choose to add D6 to the unit's move value when it activates this turn, and on a roll of a one, a random vehicle in the squad takes D3 damage points.
Gotcha, so turbo boost. And then Sam's also rolling for his last unit of two Corsairs. They come in on a 2+ this time.
There we go.
So Sam's first activation, he's going back to his command group. They are not going to move, so they can fire where they are. That denies me reaction fire. So Sam, how are you going to divide that up?
Okay, so I'll do one forward reaver into each what are they called? Rapiers?
Rapiers, yeah.
And then one rear reaver into each rapier. So the plasma hoses on the rear ones will be out of range.
Okay.
So we'll do...
So that's basically four plasma lances on each one?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And then one plasma hose on each one.
All right. So which one do you want to shoot at first?
All right. So these two will fire their lances into this one.
Okay.
Needing threes. So hit three times.
Okay. And then you need fives to destroy.
Fives to destroy. Nothing.
Nothing. But you still have one plasma hose, right?
One plasma hose, yeah. On a 3+ to hit. And let's repeat that, get another six. No.
No, all right.
So, he's
so he escapes for another round.
All right, and then I have four plasma lances into the other rapier. All hit.
All right. And then we need a five there.
Let's see if we can get a five.
Statistically, you got to kill this guy.
There we go.
Oh, he's dead twice. So he is gone. And that's their shooting now. They haven't moved yet, so you can actually move them afterwards if you want to. So Desolator has moved up within 6 inches of the building with the Praetorians in it. He's now firing his Mega Gun. He's going to hit that building on a 2+. So he hits the building, and then damage on a 2 plus, and it's a demolisher what?
D6 plus 1.
Cool. Okay. So he does 3 damage. So that's 3 falling masonry tests.
Well, to see if I double damage or not.
Oh, double damage.
So I don't double damage, and then it's D6 plus 1.
Okay.
So 5.
5 damage points to that building. Okay. So 5 falling masonry tests for the Praetorians. So we got 3, and then you wound them on 2s.
So we're 5. So
5, and I believe the Praetorian's going to save. I'm going to double check that and be right. Alright, so with the 5 damage there, we're going to take 5 4 plus dodge rolls. And only one of those is successful, so 4 Praetorians die. Activating my infantry battle group with Rapier AA tanks, I move those guys up so they can now see that Desolator down the street. And they're well within 18, so that's going to be 9 shots at Sam's Desolator needing 3s to hit. So let's go ahead and roll those. Alright, so we've got 2 misses. And I'm going to use my assisted targeting card, which lets me reroll 1 miss. So I'm going to reroll a miss, and it's still a miss. So that was a great card. And then it's energy 7. What is your Desolator's?
Armor 6.
Armor 6. So I need 4s to damage and a 6 to double damage.
Oh!
So that all is right. 6 damage points.
And that's all he's got.
That's all he's. Oh! So an early KO to the Scourge Commander.
Let me see what.
To round out the rest of that activation, the infantry that was in the street had enough distance to make it to this building, so they're cowering there in fear. The dropship carrying another squad of legionnaires moved out. It's going to try to drop to the deck to make it a little bit harder to hit, and it's fine. So he's low there. And now we're back to Scourge. These destroyers have been activated along with their minder group over there, what's left of them. Sam is activating these guys first, so they're going to roll for intel.
Oh.
And it explodes. So that's a die 6 damage points to that building. So that's 4 damage points. I'll roll for the falling masonry. We hit these guys on a 5. So we got 1 falling masonry. And then it is a, what do we say, 3 plus 2?
5 plus.
5 plus 2. So yeah. That's 1.
4 plus tough save.
No. So he takes 1 more lost destroyer there. And then that building is now at 5 more, so 15 out of 20. All right, so Sam's destroyers, after blowing up their intel, hopped into their transport. Flew over the building into the street. This last rapier in this platoon here is going to reaction fire, so that's 3 shots, needing 5s to hit him in reaction. And we get nothing. After surviving the reaction fire, that dropship dropped the destroyers off to face off against the Praetorians. Both of these units are damaged, but if the Praetorians are still there at the end of the turn, they'll be locked in CQB. But not least, the destroyers transport's going to be taking a pot shot at that lead rapier.
3 plus to hit. Hits.
So hits.
And then a 6 to damage. There we go.
Oh, so that's a shape charge, right?
No, it's a plasma hose, energy 9.
Energy 9. So that kills 1 rapier out of that unit. All right, so the minder's transport flew up here. He's also going to try to plasma hose a rapier. So he's a hit.
Miss. No.
And then the last minder in that group just kind of floated down the street a little bit. So is that it for that activation, Sam?
Yes, sir.
All right, so back to UCM. All right, I'm activating my battle group. I'm going to play intel report. During any friendly activation, I target 1 opponent, and I can force him to reveal his command card. He's only down to 1. So he has central HQ objective. Force all players to reroll their initiative. So he's going to make an initiative play. All right, sounds good. Alright, so the UCM is activating its command battle group. First up, we will go with the Praetorians that are in this building, so they're going to roll for intel. So that's one die. Please, not a one. Oh, it's a one. So that's an explosion. So how many damage points does it do to the building? It does 3 damage points to the building, so that building is now at 8. And then we need falling masonry tests for both of our units. And I believe, Sam, it's 3 for each of us.
Okay.
So I'll roll 3 for your guys, looking for 5s. Nothing. And then for my Praetorians, got 1. Damage being on 2 plus.
Nope.
So that's good. So with that exploding, those Praetorians are going to exfiltrate to their dropship, and that dropship's going to take off. And then the last thing the Praetorians do is their dropship moves 12 inches, and they jump into that building. So now they're a little bit closer to the Scourge lines, but at least it's an intel we haven't hit yet. All right, next up for my command battle group, this Eagle is going to be shooting at that building with the destroyers in it. We have 2 Energy 11 railguns, and they both hit. They double damage on a 4, so that's 4 more points of damage. And then we also have 4 missile pods hitting on 2s. Oh, they all hit. And then also damaging on 2s. So that's 4, 6 more damage.
Okay. So 18.
So that building's at 18. It's 2 away from being destroyed. So that's 10 falling masonry hits on the Scourge, needing 5. And it looks like we only got 1. And then a 5 again to wound. So that's 1 wound. And Sam has a 4 up. So that's 1 more Scourge, which I think is a stand, right?
Yes.
And then now the Phoenix, the last unit in my command unit, the commander himself, is going to fire his 2 Energy 12 chain guns at that building and 2 anti-air rockets, Energy 6, at 2 different minders. So here are the 2 chain guns, hoping to drop the building. 2 plus to hit the building, 1 hit, and 2 plus to damage. So that's 1 more damage. It's 1 away from being destroyed. Then we have 1 shot at each one of the 2 lead minders. The guy closest is all right. And the next one is hit. Energy 6 versus 4.
3.
3 is 2 plus. Yep. So the second one.
This one?
Yeah. Okay. Is now dead. So that's the Command Phoenix going back to Scourge activation. So the Scourge activate their tank company here. We have the Hunters. Their tanks have moved up the street. They turbo boosted. In the middle of the board, these anti-tank the AA tanks have moved up, and it looks like he's going to try to take out the Praetorian's ride. So we'll see what happens there. All right, so he's got a lot of dice hitting on 2s on the Praetorian's dropship.
Okay, so 6 dice hitting on 2s. One miss.
Like a lot of hits.
Killed a few cars, too.
I am armor 5.
All right, and these are energy 8.
So it looks like a 2 plus.
Got it.
So that dropship is well and truly exploded. All right, so I activated one of my tank battle groups. This battle group is the Rapiers. The one surviving Rapier has backed up 4 inches into the street. Their dropship is going to shoot a rocket at that building, hopefully knocking it out. So we need a 2 plus to hit the building, which we do, and then a 2 plus to damage the building, which we don't. Then the second activation is going to be this unit of 3 Sabers. They are going to all fire into that building, so that's going to be 6 shots hitting on 2s. So that's 6 hits. Oh, wait, you know, I rolled too many dice. Let's re-roll that. That's 5 hits.
Yay!
And then 2 plus to damage the building. Which is 4 damage, which drops the building and kills the remaining 3 destroyers in there as well. Scourge activation is going to be the second destroyer group. These destroyers here are going to roll for intel. And they find intel. So that's a 1 point for Sam. There. And then let's go to
the minders.
The destroyers weren't finished. They hopped in their dropship, flew over to this small building, and are now in the face of the Praetorians again. They just can't get away from destroyers this game. All right, so to round out that activation, the minder battle group, these minders moved in close to shoot at the Phoenix command ship, and their dropship moved over here to plasma hose the rapier. So let's go with the minders first.
They hit on a 2+.
Okay. So we got two hits.
And their energy 6.
Versus armor 5, so 4 is the damage, 6 to double damage.
Oh.
So, no damage. And then your plasma hosing over there.
Okay, 3+.
So we hit.
And a 6.
No. So that's it for Scourge activation. Alright, so over here I activated my second tank squadron. The katana's moved up. They didn't really have a target, so they're just taking some cover in case the hunters come around the corner. The falcons moved up. They stayed outside of 6 of this minder, so no reaction fire there. Only one falcon is in range of the lead hunter there. So I'm going to get, normally I hit on a 3, I think I hit on a 5 because you are a skipper.
Yeah.
So I need a 5 to hit. And where to go? Oh, there it is.
6.
6. And then it's energy 11 versus armor
8.
8. So we need 2+. So we got it. Right, so Sam activated his warrior infantry battle group. The guy who was there, their transport moved up there. He quite didn't have enough distance to unload. Now this squad of infantry is rolling for intel. And
another one.
Is it a 1?
It's a okay. 1.
Yeah. All right, so that's a 1. So the building explodes. How many damage points do we do?
2.
2 damage points. That's not bad. So we got 2 damage points. And then 2 falling masonry tests. We got 1.
Okay.
And that's 2+ to wound. So it looks like 1 dead warrior. So the warriors, after the building exploded, they hopped in their transport. Now they're tooling towards their next target. Back to a UCM. So I activated my last of the tiny infantry squad. They bailed out of that building. They're in the transport flying over here. So we're back over to Sage, to Sam with the Scourge activation. So Sam Scourge, we have his air group activating next. He's going to try to bring in 2 Corsairs and attack run on my Phoenix. He needs a 2+ to successfully call them in, and he's got it. So they're there. I don't have any reaction fire, so he's got 2 shots on my Phoenix.
All right, 4+. 2 hits.
He has 2 hits.
Energy 11.
Versus armor 5.
2s.
2s.
3 damage.
3 damage. So that is 3 out of 9. So that ship's tough. All right, so Sam's second squadron, which is now down to 1 Corsair, is trying to come in on a 2+.
Got it, barely.
And then I'm trying to intercept with my 1 Archangel, so can he come in as well? Yes, he can. So the Archangel is going to try to intercept here. Normally I hit on a 3+, it's a 5+ because it's an interception, so I'm looking for 5s. 2 shots with my energy 7 cannon, both of them miss. So my Archangel zips on through having done nothing, and Sam's Corsair moves on uncontested to shoot at my command ship again. So he has 1 shot on a 4+, which he gets, and then a 2 for damage. He scores 2 more damage points. That puts the Phoenix at 5 with 4 left. All right, so the end of turn 3, it got pretty exciting here. Sam had his Scourge come in full force. Unfortunately, he lost his decimator, his command unit, in the exchange. He did have a very good air phase, though, and managed to tag 5 points of damage on my Phoenix command ship. Here is the destroyed so far. Looks like we've got the Desolator, Corsair, 4 Minders, couple squads of destroyers, 5 minders, and 1 hunter grav tank. I have lost 2 light dropships, 3 rapiers, and I've got 1 shot up command vehicle. Going into turn 4. Alright, so we're starting turn 4 initiative roll. I still have my commander, Sam does not, so I get a command value +4 to this roll. So I've got a 5. Ooh. Sam has a 1. So Sam, do you wish to play a card?
I'm going to play Central HQ Directive.
Oh, and what does that do again?
So it forces all players to reroll their initiative, and then I may do so with a command value of 5, and my command value reverts to its actual level after this roll.
Alright, so you are back at plus 1 on me for this roll, because I'm a command value 4.
Okay.
So
did not help me.
I still got initiative. So now we're off to draw cards. Alright, so now I drew up command cards. I get 4 command cards. Sam is only at 1 because his commander is dead. I am playing in the cleanup phase my Phoenix Field Repairs, which lets me repair 1 damage point. I'm also playing, sorry Sam, Field Repairs, which lets me repair 1 point. So I'm now at 3 damage points and 6 left. So now we're going to go on to turn, activation 1. All right, for UCM's first activation, I'm activating the infantry battle group with the attached rapiers. There are 2 rapiers left here, so they're going to fire over the destroyed building at these gunships. I'm going to put 3 dice into each of the 2 lead gunships. I need 3s to hit, so here's on the closest gunship. We score 2 hits. It's energy 7 versus armor 5, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So we need 3s to damage, and we score 1 point of damage on that one.
This one?
Yeah, that one. And then the other rapier's firing on that fella. 3s to hit, we have 2 hits, 3s to damage, and nothing. So that is their fire. They're going to move back just a little bit, get out of the street. Then on to the infantry. Next up, I'm going to move the dropship for the rapiers. He's going to move across here to get a shot at the Scourge AA tanks, and Sam has chosen to reaction fire. So, Sam, how many are you going to?
I'll reaction fire all 3.
All right, so that's all 3. Those have how many shots each?
2 apiece.
2 apiece. So that's 6 shots hitting on 4s?
Normally, yeah, 4s with command value reaction fire. So 3 hit.
And I am armor 5.
Energy 8.
So, ooh, so 2s.
So 3.
3 damage is enough to destroy him, so he is destroyed. Alright, for the infantry, the first squad moved up here. Dumped out into this building to search for that intel next turn. And then for this squad, I played Call for Extraction, which lets me bring in 1 replacement transport. So we're bringing in a Raven dropship to pick them up and move them out. So we'll make that move now. They hop in their newly arrived transport and fly that way. They don't have enough distance to unload. That makes Scourge first activation. So Sam has activated the Scourge command battle group minus the commander. These 4 gunships are going to try to take out all my AA. I don't have any reaction fire because they are not moving. They are shooting where they are. So Sam, you want to fire whatever's going here?
So these 2 are going to fire into this rapier. So I have 4 plasma lances hitting on 3s.
Through 4 hits. All 4 hit. Ouch.
And 5s to destroy. There we go.
Alright, so he is gone. The last rapier of that squad. Alright.
I'm going to fire this Reaver, into this rapier. Too many hard words. 2 plasma lances. 1 hit.
Oh, and a 5 up to destroy.
5 up. No. Roll the 1. Okay, and then the other one, same thing, 2 plasma lances, both miss.
2 here, oh, okay.
Alright, and now I'll move them.
Now you can move, yeah. Alright, so I'm activating my command battle group, which is my Phoenix, my Praetorians, and my Eagle gunship. First up, I'm going to activate the Praetorians, and I'm going to play Soldiers of the Resistance, which gives me D3 plus 1 lost damage points from a base. So I have 1 guy that's down 4 damage points. So here's that roll, Sam. We've got 1 plus 1, 2. So I am healed 2 guys that I thought were dead. Now that the card is played, I'm going to try to reveal the intel. So here's the intel roll 4, so it's just a regular piece of intel. I find it giving me 3 points, but if I die and you survive, you could possibly score that same piece of intel.
Works for me.
So that's those Praetorians. Next up, I'm going to move the Phoenix. I'm going to go ahead and make that move, and then we'll come back for some shit. So the Phoenix moved up 4, letting these two Minders reaction fire. So normally hitting on 2s, so 4s.
Nothing.
All right. The Phoenix moved up. It's now going to fire everything it can into those AA hovercraft there. So that's going to be one large blast, two chain guns. We'll double-check the range. And then I'll keep my missile pods to protect me for AA. All right, so we're going to fire the missile pod first. That's going to go over here. We're going to try to cover all 3. I'm going to hit on a 3, which we do. So that will cover all 3 with energy 10 blast.
Ouch.
So if you want to point, Sam, I'll roll for each one. So those are armor what?
8.
8, so I'm killing them on 3s?
Yeah.
Ooh, okay. So here's here's that one.
Got him.
He's dead. The next one was dead. 3. And the last one is dead. Nice. Last but not least, the Eagle moved over 6 and is firing his rail guns at that hunter that's in the middle of the street. Normally they hit on 3s, 5s because he is a skimmer. 2 shots at energy 11. That's one hit at energy 11, so I believe that's a 2 to destroy.
Yeah, armor 8.
Armor 8 versus 11. So we roll a 1, so he's okay. All right, so that concludes the UCM activation, so back over to Scourge. All right, we forgot something very important. CQB was triggered since the Praetorians were the occupier of that building. There are 8 Praetorians still alive there. There are 6 destroyers. So Sam's going to go first with his 18 dice, hitting on 4s.
Ooh, that's pretty good. I'll take that.
So I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 hits.
Yeah.
So if I don't dodge any of those, I'm dead. So I...
You lost 2.
I lost 2. So I lose the 2 guys I just healed for 4. Now, I am rolling 24 dice. But I'm only hitting on 6s. So, and we lost 1 off the table, so we reroll that. And I only see 1, 4, 5.
5?
So, and Sam's guys also have a 4 plus because they're tough destroyers.
I also lose 2.
Alright, so I think we both lost 2, so we're still locked into combat because neither one of us lost. Well, that was a little anticlimactic.
Yeah, a little bit.
All right, so we're going to Scourge activation. All right, so Sam activated the Scourge Warrior battle groups. Looks like they both piled into buildings. So we don't have any search rolls this turn, Crazy.
Correct.
All right, so it's back to UCM. All right, I'm going to activate my tank battle group. That's 3 katanas here and the 2 falcons. I'm just going to have them move up a little bit. And they're going to take shots at those 2 grav tanks in the middle of the road. 1 shot at each. Normally 3s, I need 5s because of their skimmer. The guy on my left, we will hit. And the guy on my right, we will miss. So energy 11 versus armor 8 means I destroy on a 2 or better.
Which one was it? This one?
That was the first one, so yes, that one.
All right,
so that's the Falcon, or sorry, yeah, the Falcons. All right, so Sam activated his warrior group, sorry, the destroyer group. Those destroyers are tied up in CQB. However, their transports have zipped over here. One moved too fast to fire, but the Minder's transport, this fella right here, is going to be shooting at one of the katanas. So, go ahead and roll that, Sam.
3 plus to hit.
So you hit. I am only armor 9 with the katana, so that's a 5.
5, yeah. 5 plus. Nope.
So no, the katana's okay. All right, is that it for that battle group, Sam?
That's it.
All right, the UCM, I'm activating my second tank battle group, which is this unit of katanas and those 2 rapiers. The rapiers have already fired, so they're going to stay where they are. The katanas are going to put their six shots into that building. So we're going to hit that building on twos. So we got five hits. And we're going to damage that building on twos. So fours give us double damage. So that is eight more damage to that unit. All right, so Sam has activated his destroyer minder unit. The minder sidled over and is going to take a shot at a Falcon dropship. Gunship.
Two to hit?
Oh, and misses.
Nothing.
All right, so those guys will live another
day. I will fire plasma hose into a katana. All
right.
Katana three. No, nothing. And then I just need to move this one over. And
this is the dropship for the warriors who are, these are the dead warriors. Right?
Mm-hmm. Okay. And then one more shot. Does hit on a three.
Right, and then a five to destroy.
Five to destroy. Nothing.
Alright.
That's it.
That's Scourge activation. And my activation, I activated my tiny infantry battle group, just one transport with two guys, and it moves over there. They don't unload this turn. So back over to Sam. So Sam activated the Scourge tank group. It's just a single hunter here taking a shot at a single katana in cover, Sam, would you say?
Yeah.
Okay. So four up to hit?
Nope.
Oh, okay. Anything else with that?
That's it.
All right, so back to UCM, which I think is just air, which I think I will not use, so I can save it for reaction. Sam is going to try to activate his Corsairs. He does it on a 2+.
So the unit of two Corsairs is in.
They come in.
The unit of one Corsair is also in.
All right. So we rolled, the Corsairs came in, my Archangel was able to intercept. This group of two Corsairs is going after that loaded light transport, so let's do that one first, Sam.
All right, so two shots hitting on fours, one hit.
Oh, one hit, all right, armor five.
And energy 11.
Oh. All right, so now we need to roll on the, that transport's destroyed, so we need to roll on the table, so let's roll a die. And five.
Crash landing. A messy and final return to Earth. Any units transported is destroyed on a roll of 4+.
All right, so I've got two stands in there, so if you want to make 2 4+'s, see if you kill them. One. So one of the stands is dead. Those are undamaged, so it doesn't matter which one is which. That's gone, and the infantry are left in the open. Over here, this Corsair is making an attack run on that light dropship, also packed with troops. However, I was able to call in my Archangel. He's going to try to intercept. I've got two shots, needing fives to hit. Oops. Well, one big miss, and one hit. And then it's energy seven versus your armor of
five.
Five. So I need three up or five better to do 2 points of damage.
Oop.
So 1 point.
That's enough.
Oh, that's enough. Of course, it only has one damage point. So the Archangel manages to shoot down one Corsair before zooming off himself. All right, so we're going to roll initiative. I am at plus four. So we are tied, so we reroll up. So I think I got it that time. All right, so I will activate first. All right, so I activated my infantry battle group first because that has my rapiers. Those guys just hoofed it into the building, so on the last turn, next turn, they'll be able to search. Those guys over there are in the building, so they're going to search that intel. Let's see what we get. Three, so it's just intel. So that puts me at 4 points to Sam's one or two?
One so far, yeah.
Okay. Those guys will mount up to their dropship, and the dropship's just going to carry them over to the next building. Over here, I've got two rapiers left. They're going to fire at these two dropships. They're actually going to move a little bit so that if you become a flaming wreck, you're not going to crash on them. So that's going to give me three shots. We'll go three shots on him and three shots on him.
That one's a light dropship.
Oh, that one's a light dropship.
You want to do this one?
So, yeah, that one and that.
All right.
So here's the one on the closest gunship to me. We scored two hits.
Okay, and he's damaged already.
And he's damaged, so I'm looking for energy seven versus five.
Uh-huh.
So threes. So we can do 2 damage, which is enough to down him. And then on this dropship, we're going to fire 3 more dice. We got 2 hits. And we're looking for 3s to damage. We do double damage, which kills another one. All right, so Sam is activating his infantry, his warrior battle group. The first one is in this tall building. They're going to search for intel and see what they find. Oh, no. It explodes. And how much damage does that do, Sam?
6.
Oh, 6 damage points. So that is 6 falling masonry checks. I'll go ahead and see what we can do here. We're looking for 5s to hurt with falling masonry. So we've got 3 falling masonry hits, which translates to 2. Only 2 more dead.
Okay.
So then, are they bailing out? I think that's the third piece of intel that has exploded for Sam. So those guys are falling back into their dropship.
I think they're just going to drive off the board at this point.
And they're going to drive off the board.
That's not long range play. I guess they'll just head this way. 3 inches. Okay.
And then that other warrior group?
Mm-hmm. 4.
So they find intel. As the roof caves in. And then I imagine they're also collapsing into their APC.
And they'll go 3 inches to the next one.
All right, so I'm activating my small infantry group. The Raven's going to unload, so we have 2 stands of Legionnaires joining that fight. And then this little guy is just going to move over here to make it. And that's all our activation. Back over to Scourge. All right, so Sam has activated his Minders and Destroyers. These 2 Minders are going to fire at the Phoenix command ship, so they're hitting on 2s, which they do. And then I'm armor 5.
Energy 6.
So 4s.
Nothing.
So that is nothing. And then over here, we've got the Minders dropship is going to be firing into a Katana.
It's on a 3.
So it hits, and then a 5 to destroy.
Yep.
Got it. So which one were you aiming at, Sam?
The closest one.
Alright. So that's a Katana kill. And then the Destroyer's dropship is firing at another Katana.
Closest one. On a 3 to hit. No, I missed.
Alright. Is that it for that group?
That's it.
Alright, so back over to UCM. Alright, so I moved my Phoenix. It's idled over a little bit to get fire on that hover tank over there, that Hunter. We're going to shoot 2 energy 12 chain guns at him. Normally hitting on 3s, so I need 5s because of Sam's skimming. So here we go, and we miss. So that is everything from the Phoenix. We're going to save our missile pods for AA defense. The Eagle is going to sidle over enough for a shot as well. So it's going to roll its 2 energy 11 guns, also need 5s. And we got 1 hit. Energy 11. I believe I needed 2+.
Mm-hmm.
And we got him. So the last Hunter is destroyed. The last part of that activation is going to be the Praetorians versus the Destroyers, round 2. So we'll go ahead and set up with all of our dice here. Alright, so we checked the rules on this CQB. The Legionnaires who joined the battle, since they entered the building this turn, do not contribute to the CQB. So it's just 6 Legionnaires versus 4 Destroyers. So Sam's going to go ahead and roll his dice.
4 pluses. Ooh.
Oh, I see a lot of 1s there.
3 hits.
Just 3 hits. Alright, so I get 3 dodge rolls. And looks like 1 more is dead, which is enough to kill 1 stand of Praetorians. Then the Praetorians swing back. This happens simultaneously, so I'm still rolling 18 dice. If I can pick them all up. And And here we go. I'm only hitting on sixes. And it looks like we've got two. Does that look right?
Yeah.
Two. All right, so Sam has a four save, four plus save.
Good.
And he makes two. So I have lost the CQB. We're going to check to see what I need. All right, so we checked the rule book since they... Praetorians have to be at less than half of their starting value to roll for morale. They are not. They are at half. So we don't roll for morale, and we're still locked in for, looks like, one more round in turn six. So Sam is activating the battle group with the minders and the transport for the dead destroyers. So a couple of his transports are going to be shooting at katanas. So let's do those first.
So intruder into the closest katana. Hits on a three. Hits.
Oh, three. All right. And then five to destroy.
No.
No.
Same target from the second intruder.
Okay.
Hits. Nothing.
And then you also were firing this minder over here into the closest Falcon?
Yeah.
All right.
Hits on a two.
You got it.
And damage is on a four.
Four.
Energy six to five.
Armor five. Yep.
Got him.
Got him. Double so damage. This Falcon crashes. Alright, so Sam is activating his gunship command battle group. It's just these two guys left. Basically, they're splitting their fire, so we're getting a plasma hose into each one of those two katanas, and then two plasma lances into each one of those two rapiers. So, however you want to roll, Sam.
Okay, we'll do this reaver first. Fires plasma hose into that katana.
Okay.
Hits on a three.
Hits.
Destroys on a five. No. And then two lances into the closest rapier. Hits on threes. Two hits.
Sixes.
Five.
Oh, five.
And no. Yep. Adds to a five. All right. All right. Second one, we'll fire one hose into the closest katana.
Sure.
Hits on a three. Damages on a five. Got him.
Oh, all right. So that katana...
And then two lances into the next rapier.
Okay, that good.
One hit.
Okay.
And damages on a five.
Got him. All right. So two more UCM tanks down. All right, so I activated my second tank battle group, which is just one surviving katana. It drove down the road to try to escape the hell that's being unleashed from those gunships. So it's back to Scourge. Alright, so Scourge is activating their air unit, so he's going to try to bring in his two Corsairs on a 2+, which he does. I'm going to try to intercept, so here's my intercept roll, which I do, right? It's 2+?
Two plus.
Okay. Alright, so the Archangel's going to get a shot. It's going to shoot at, it doesn't matter which one, they're identical. I'm looking for fives.
Okay.
And I miss, so they can move on their attack run. When they get within 18 of the Phoenix, I'm going to reaction fire there. We're going to put one shot into each. Maybe we'll get lucky. Your range is 12, right?
It's like 6. It's pretty short.
Oh, 6. So my reaction fire definitely
would
go off first. All right. So normally 3, so 5s, the Corsair in the front and the Corsair in the back. Missed both of those, so he can make his attack run unmolested.
All right, it'll be 4s to hit you. I hit once.
All right. And then armor 5.
So energy 11, so 2s to damage, 4s for double damage. I double damage.
All right, so I'm back to 5 damage points. And then those guys fly off. So last turn of the game, we're going to roll for initiative. I'm up by 4 on this roll, so I got a 5, and Sam wins it with a 6,
hey,
so he gets to go first. So Sam is activating his command battle group, which right now just is 2 Ravagers?
Reavers.
Reavers. And they are going to be firing where, Sam?
So this one will fire its plasma hose and both of its plasma lances into the rapier. This one will fire its plasma hose into the rapier and its 2 plasma lances into 2 separate katanas.
Oh, all right.
So the first one firing into the rapier, 2 plasma lances. That's one hit.
That's like one hit.
And I damage you on a 5. Got him.
All right, so he is exploded.
The this one can't fire its hose anymore, so we'll fire its left and right plasma lance. Its right plasma lance into the first katana. It's on a 3. Damages on a, you're at armor 9. So 4 plus. Got it.
Alright, so it's this one?
Yes.
Okay.
And then the left lance will fire hitting on a 3 and damaging on a 4. Got it.
And that's this one?
Yes.
Alright, so good round of shooting. 3 more UCM tanks down. Alright, so first up, I'm activating my command unit. I'm going to run a black project on my Phoenix. I'm going to try to keep him alive by the end of the game. So basically all that does is Sam can only hit him on 6s this turn, so he's going to be extra hard to kill. My Eagle really doesn't have anything to do, so he's just going to stay there. And then the big thing is we're going to trigger CQB over here. So now we have two UCM units, one stand of 5 Praetorians and 2 stands of 10 Legionnaires. So Sam has to split his dice between the two, so he's going 6 dice against each one. He's still hitting on 4s for both of those.
Okay, so into the Praetorians. 4 hits.
Alright, so I get 4 dodge rolls for Praetorians. And 3 die. So that leaves them with 2 lives. And then 6 against the Legionnaires.
2 hits.
2 hits. So those guys have no armor or dodge or anything like that, so those guys take 2 as well. Now they're swimming back with 25 dice. Again, I'm looking for 6s. Alright, so here's 25 dice. We need 6s to hit. So we've got, looks like 3 6s?
5.
Oh, 5. Alright, so Sam has 5, 4 up saves to take. And he makes all but 1.
That's enough to lose a stand.
So that's a stand. So he is also at half strength. So he does not need to make a morale check, but now my Praetorians do. They have a 3 up value for staying, and they stay. So that game is going to end with those guys locked in combat. Alright, so the Minder and battle group with the Destroyers activate. The 2 dropships are going to be shooting at that katana, so they're both going to be trying to take it out. They hit on 3s?
Yeah, 3 plus. So first one hits. And damage?
Nope.
Second one hits. Yes. And damage? Yes.
So 5 is enough to destroy it. So all the katanas are now... Oh no. 1 katana's left. He's running away. Aha. So that's it for them. The Minder in that unit just kind of floated over down the street a little bit. He really doesn't have anything else to do in this game. And I'm going to activate my infantry platoon. So it's going to be these guys here. They're going to roll for intel. So they've got a 3, so it's just a piece of intel. That puts me up to 5. They'll stay there to sit out the game. The other platoon of Legionnaires, or squad of Legionnaires, is there. They already activated, so they're done. Their dropships aren't going to do anything. The only thing left for them is this dropship here, and he's just going to fly down the street a little bit. Just get out of the way. And then it's back to Sam and his crew. So Sam's second destroyer unit activates. Basically just their dropships are going to go after this last katana, so he's got a couple shots there to go for.
3's to hit. Did hit.
Alright. And then a 5.
Oh. Second one. Missed.
Alright, so that katana will live to fight another day. Back over to UCM. Okay, my really small infantry battle group will activate. It's just down to 1 squad of infantry there. They're going to search for intel. And...
Oh, it's an objective.
It's an objective, so they score 1 point. That becomes an objective, but it doesn't really matter much for game purposes because I can't get it off the board this turn. So that puts me up to 6. So Sam's going to try to activate his 2 Corsairs in that 1 squad, so he needs a 2 plus to bring him on.
Got it.
And he does. I'm going to try to intercept with my Archangel. And we don't, so he buzzes around doing nothing. Now Sam's 2 Corsairs are going to go after that poor dropship.
Okay, so it's 2 4 pluses to hit.
All right.
Two hits.
Two hits. Armor 5.
Energy 11. Twos. Got him.
So that
boxcars.
That dropship is exploded. No more. All right, and then the Corsairs fly off with no. All right, so I think we're going to call the game here. It's the end of turn 6. We are at 6 victory points for the UCM and 2 for the Scourge. Unfortunately for the Scourge, they had 3 intel pieces explode in their face, or else I think this would have been a little bit closer in points. Destruction-wise, well, you can kind of see at the table there, a lot has died. I think all but one UCM tank, quite a few flyers, about 2/3 of Sam's army is dead as well. So anyway, Sam, thanks for the game.
Good game, John.
I get that on there. And we'll see you next time. Thanks.